sorry. うまく笑えないよ。あなたの喜びわからないのに。I know I'm so lost. 大層笑いでごまかせない。
Va bene ragazzi, riprendiamo l'avventura di Judgment, è giunto il momento di tornare a riposare. Però invece no, qualcosa sta succedendo.
Kuroa,
oh, polizia.
I've been waiting for you. Why don't we step inside for a little chat?
Another voluntary interrogation? Thought I told you to bring a warrant next time.
The hell was that? Let's be civilized here, Yagami-san.
Fine. Office is pretty dirty, though.
Il poliziotto corrotto è anche un po' nostro amico, ci ha fatto segno con la testa, quindi accettiamo di buon grado. Buon grado è un parolone, però.
There's a leak in the prosecutor's office. Pretty sure it's a woman. Got her hands on some pretty important case files.
Ma foglio.
One's about the vice director of the ADDC getting beaten to death in the street. You have any ideas?
Sorry, not a clue.
What kind of lowlife would sell police secrets? Shh. Scum. Right, Ayabe?
Totally. The worst.
È quello che fa come secondo lavoro a Yabe, però.
Nobody takes us seriously around here.
That all you came to ask? I'm sure you guys are just as busy as I am. So, if you're finished, I'm gonna have to ask you to...
Right. Izumita wants to talk to you tomorrow. About Shintani's murder. You'll be there. In cuffs, if need be.
Allora questi non sono che i galoppini di Izumida.
Why am I being treated like a suspect?
Sorry, that's classified. Just drop by the public prosecutor's office. If you're innocent, you have nothing to worry about.
You don't want to deal with getting arrested. Trust me. Better to handle this before it gets to that point. Think of it like that.
Thanks for the advice.
Besides, you and Izumita go way back.
But how am I going to defend myself if I don't know why he suspects me? Let me guess. I'll find out when I get there.
More or less. Who knows what angle Izumita will take.
Have it your way. I'll come in and clear the air and we'll be done with this.
I'll be in touch tomorrow.
Asshole's been dragging me everywhere. I can't do a damn thing on my own.
I can tell. Looks rough.
Va bene, ragazzi, è il momento di andare a letto. Finalmente scopriremo perché la polizia ci continua a dare la caccia, che in realtà noi non abbiamo fatto niente.
Hello, Yagami-san?
Hey, any luck?
Yes, I made friends
Ah, è
with the
vero,
girl who
raga.
served Hoshki 6 months ago. We're gonna bounce and go to Tender in a few.
Perfect. Wait, did you just say bounce?
È vero, raga, sta parte io me l'ero dimenticata perché 2 video fa Saori si è infiltrata dentro il cabaret dove... Vabbè, quello perché ho picchiato i farabutti che c'erano le... Pirossino rosso, vabbè. Ci dà sti pirosseni che non sapendo ancora, non ho capito cosa servono. Vabbè, niente, Saori praticamente si è infiltrata dentro il cabaret dove c'era questa ragazza di intrattenimento che ha avuto a che fare con Ishii, come cacchio si chiama? Faccio un casino ora con i nomi. Allora, scusate, eh. Ishiki, e dovrebbe aver scoperto qualcosa. Adesso loro si sono al tender e magari riesce a spillarli qualche informazione. Qua c'è sempre la nostra amica.
Sorry, son.
Took you long enough. This is Mika-san.
Hey, I'm Yagami. Mind if I join you?
Be my guest.
This is the man you served 6 months ago? You're certain?
Yeah, that's him.
We already discussed Hoshki and Shono. Mika-san was at their table, without a doubt.
That's Shono-san, right?
Yeah. What were they like?
I guess nothing stood out about them more than any other pair of businessman types. Hoshki-san complained about his boss, while Shono-san just nodded and smiled.
What was Hoshki saying?
He was going on and on about this Kido-san guy. Have you heard about that new dementia drug, 89?
Yeah, I'm kind of familiar.
Not surprised. They used to talk about it on TV a bunch. Anyway, apparently Kido-san's kind of a big shot guy on the 89 research team.
And Hoshki and Shono were talking shit about him?
Yeah. Sounds like Kido-san was getting wined and dined by all sorts of people who wanted to profit off 89. From what I heard, not all those deals were above board.
Secret deals, huh? Is Kido-san working with the Yakuza?
Hoshki-san didn't give specifics, but he did say 89 could buy a lot of influence. And about the cut he'd be getting later. He seemed like a really shady guy, actually.
Interesting.
Ti ricordi molto di Ashiki? È stato fuori il nome Kaijira. Ha recitato bene, sono. Sentiamo il nome Kaijira, che vediamo se sono collegati.
Did you ever hear Hashiki mention a Kajihira?
Kajihira.
It's a big construction company based out of Kansai. Basically, Hoshki was working for this Kajihira, trying to shut down the ADDC.
Wait, I thought Hoshki-san was super important, like vice director or something.
He was. Kajihira's money was too much for him to refuse, though.
Either way, I don't remember hearing them talk about a Kajihira.
Ricordi
I gotta
molto di
say, you
Ashiki.
remember a lot for a conversation that happened 6 months ago.
Can you blame me? The poor man got beaten to death right afterward. I replay this a lot.
Right. Sorry.
And at that point, I already knew about 89. See, my grandma has pretty bad Alzheimer's. So I was hoping they'd release it to the public soon.
I'm sure that made the conversation stick out to you.
Yeah, When I heard Kido-san was just another slime ball, I don't know, kind of broke my heart.
Tragic. How was Shono acting that night at the club?
Well, he spent most of the night staring at my chest. Hashiki-san kept going on about Kido-san all the same, though.
Maintain eye contact, Yagami-san.
Shono-san seemed more interested in being a creep than indulging him, though.
You don't think he was listening to Hashiki-san, then?
Nope. Didn't seem like it.
Disgruntled boss on one side, closet perv on the other.
But then, out of the blue, Hashiki-san said this.
There's something fishy going on with 89, I just know it.
Did he have any idea what it was?
What did he say again? Something about fabrication or falsification?
Data fabrication? Falsifying the effects of the drug?
Yeah, that was it. He kept going on about how AD9 was too good to be true. And how weird it is that it just came out of nowhere.
So he brought Shono to the club to try and
Right.
What did Shono say?
Just, there's nothing fishy about it.
But then Hashiki-san yelled back,
I don't believe that for a second.
It was kind of awkward seeing how desperate he was.
Makes sense he'd be desperate, though.
Why?
He promised this guy Kajihiro he'd shut down the ADDC. Thanks
però,
for this, Mika-chan.
Non c'è detto nulla di nuovo, sinceramente.
Yeah, you helped us more than you know. Be safe on your way back.
Thank you.
What time's your shift start tomorrow, Saturday?
Ha confermato cose che già sapevamo.
Sorry, I'm not coming back tomorrow.
Huh?
It was a one-night thing. I got to see a side of myself I didn't know I had, though.
Man, this stinks. You're so pretty, Saori-san, and I was pumped to learn more from you.
I don't think I have much left to teach. I might be able to help you, though, as a friend.
You're a lawyer?
Let me know if you ever get into trouble.
Wow, I've never been friends with a lawyer before. This is like super cool. Thanks so much. Bye now.
That was amazing, Saori-san. You really pulled through for us.
It's fine.
Come on, I'll walk you back to the office. I want to review what we learned with Hoshino-kun and the others.
Sure.
Andiamo a fare il punto della situazione. In realtà non ci ha detto nulla, perché Hashiki era in... era super, diciamo, corrotto, se così si può dire, dalla, dall'impresa di costruzione, che aveva appunto ricevuto una mazzetta, voleva a tutti i costi che l'azienda chiudesse, di conseguenza sperava in tutti i modi che il farmaco si rivelasse poi qualcosa di finto, ecco. Però questo ancora non lo sappiamo, abbiamo i sospetti. Abbiamo dei sospetti che il farmaco sia uscito in un momento cruciale, proprio quando la società farmaceutica stava per essere chiusa. E molto probabilmente è stato un asso nella manica per fare in modo di restare in vita, no? Parlo proprio dell'azienda. Di conseguenza, però, non c'è stata nessuna prova, solamente spettegolezze di cui già eravamo al corrente. Nulla di nuovo, ritorniamo indietro. Magari passo anche dal market a prendere qualche cibaria.
Welcome back. You're so beautiful, Saori-san.
Like a puppy. You should dress like that all the time, Saori-kun.
Yeah, good luck finding clients.
I'm changing.
Guarda quell'altro come la segue.
There's a good chance Hashiki's murder was premeditated. Just like Chairman Kajihira suspected.
That's the conclusion you and Saori-kun reached?
Yeah. Hashiki thought something was up with 89. Doubted the authenticity of the research. Seemed convinced they had fabricated data. He was desperately searching for proof before he died.
But was there anything actually wrong with it?
I tried analyzing the paper myself to find out, but it's like it was written in a different language. I'm searching for someone more knowledgeable as we speak. But nobody seems to suspect any foul play, not even online.
Yet Hashiki was still searching for issues, and if he had managed to find one...
The ADDC would be long gone by now.
Then they murdered Hashiki to keep the secret safe?
Don't be ridiculous. Who would kill a man just to protect a research paper?
It might not be as unlikely as you think. The ADDC has been bringing in billions of government yen ever since they published that paper. With that much cash involved, bumping someone off wouldn't be out of the question.
The question is, who killed Hashiki?
Il colpevole ha fatto in modo che Hashiki non morisse sul colpo, è stato piuttosto abile.
A professional assassin, if I had to guess. The man in the black raincoat.
If he was an assassin, that would mean someone hired him.
Yeah. Someone who wanted to protect 89 and the ADDC.
But who?
Can't begin to imagine. But apparently Kido was out hyping up 89, raking in tons of dirty money in the process. Guy might even be involved with the Yakuza.
You're really suspicious of him, Yagami-san.
Well, if it looks like a rat.
Maybe Shintani got too close to the truth, and Kido offed him for it.
The thought has crossed my mind. Don't think we can say that for sure without looking more into Kido, though.
But judging from our last visit, that won't be as easy as you make it sound. He's practically a celebrity at this point.
Well, maybe if we can't get him to talk, prosecutor's office can.
Huh? What do you mean?
I've got a meeting with Izumita tomorrow. They're calling me in.
Isn't that the prosecutor who was trying to get you arrested?
He can try all he wants. That's what this meeting's about.
No chance in hell he agrees to help us, then.
All depends on how this little chat goes. If I can convince him I'm innocent, I'll clear my name and put the squeeze on Kido all in one fell swoop.
What are you planning, Yagami-san?
Ok, riposa verso l'agenzia investigativa. Va bene, dai, niente, raga, andiamo a riposare e andiamo poi domani al... Andiamo a riposare e niente, vediamo e andiamo a affrontare poi... I nostri poliziotti. Siamo a un momento decisivo, eh? Finalmente, casa dolce casa. Oh, Tamioka-san ha lasciato uno dei suoi manicaretti. È un hamburger. Vabbè, teniamolo per dopo, ragazzi. Tanto c'è la salute strapiena.
Yo.
È ancora qua.
Got a message for you from Kuroiwa. Says to drop by the Tokyo Public Prosecutor's office. Izumita's waiting for you.
Why'd you have to come here to tell me that? Would have been easier to talk on the phone.
I got a bad feeling about all this.
Huh?
Feels like I'm never gonna see you again if you get yourself locked up now.
Come on, don't be like that. Even if I do get arrested, I won't say a word about your little side job. That's what you're worried about, right?
Yep. I might have to send someone to bump you off in prison if you rat me out.
Like you could pull that off. Aren't you busy dusting off Kuroiwa's boots?
I'm laying low, that's all.
Speaking of, I have a question for you now that you're off your leash. Why do they think I killed Shintani? They have to have a reason, right? You've gotta know.
Well, funny enough, I don't. Kuroiwa won't share a shred of info with anyone but his closest partners. Not sure why.
Gotcha.
Now, get over to the prosecutor's office. Sorry, but you gotta cover your own cab fare.
Yeah, I know.
Va bene, ragazzi, un nuovo giorno in procura. Fantastico, incominciamo bene. La tariffa base 451 yen, ufficio del pubblico ministero.
I've been waiting for you, Yagami-san.
Rolling out the red carpet, huh?
Izumita was hoping you'd lower your guard if I was the first person you saw here.
The man never changes. He loves his mind games.
Yagami-kun, how did they convince you to come?
I heard your pal Izumita wants to chat. And depending on what I say, he may or may not try to arrest me.
I'm not sure it'll be quite like that.
Huh? Then what's it gonna be?
Well, you're about to get thrown to the wolves.
Hey, Mafuyu.
Good luck. Excuse me. I've brought Yagami-san.
Much appreciated.
Huh. Even the chief prosecutor's in on this.
Please, come in.
So these are the wolves. A room full of prosecutors, huh?
Yagami-sensei, I believe Kuroiwa-san already told you this, but we want to talk to you about Shintani-sensei's murder. However, this is not a courtroom. And we're not strangers. Or wolves. Just try to relax.
Yeah, relax, right. I'm not telling you what you want to hear, though. You want me to say I killed Shintani, right? Sorry, not happening. The burden of proof's on you, anyway. So why don't we start there? Why do you think I did it?
Yagami-sensei, where were you on the night of Shintani-sensei's murder?
Answer my question with another question? That's not very nice.
Do you have an alibi for that evening?
You heard of a company called KJ Art? The place is a front for some Kansai Yakuza, the Kyore clan. On the night of the crime, I was near there with their captain, Shioya. He'll back my story up, I'm sure.
And care to explain why Shintani-sensei's corpse was found in your office?
I was hoping you could tell me. Maybe the real killer could answer that for you.
Naturally. That's why I called you here.
Maledizione, non hanno mai avuto intenzione di ascoltare quello che ho da dire. Dovevamo aspettarcelo.
Go right ahead, Morita-san.
Yagami-san, you stole a look at Shintani-sensei's call history before the police arrived, yes? Not long before his death, he placed a call to the Advanced Drug Development Center. Knowing that, you barged into the center and interrogated both Kido-san and Shono-san. Why would you do such a thing?
I wanted to figure out what made Shintani a target, who wanted him dead.
Is that not the police's job?
I couldn't leave it to them, or the prosecution. After all, you guys have a bad habit of going after the wrong guy. Kinda like right now.
I see. So you mean to imply someone else killed Shintani-sensei? Do you have anything that could prove that claim?
Tocca all'accusa presentare le prove. Sono qui proprio per questo. Ci penso io. Sono qui proprio per questo.
That's the only reason I'm here.
Oh,
How responsible of you.
The prosecution's proven unreliable, after all. I've been working my ass off because of you guys. Now, can we begin?
Yes. You have the floor, Yagami.
Questa è una buona occasione. Ora potrò conoscere il punto di vista dell'accusa sul caso di Shintani.
Before we get to Shintani's murder, there are a few things I need to cover. 1 year ago, the ADDC published a research paper on a new drug they were developing called 89. This drug has gained global recognition as the thing that may finally cure Alzheimer's disease. What hasn't gained recognition is the fact that someone from the ADDC was murdered 6 months ago.
An ADDC member murdered? Who?
Yoji Shono, lo scienziato, no? L'infermiera, no? Hashiki.
The vice director, Toru Hashiki. Hashiki was seen arguing with a strange man in Kamurocho before being found lying beaten in the street. He died in the hospital 3 weeks later. The culprit is still at large. Did you know of this case?
It's the first I've heard of it.
Understandable. It didn't make many headlines. Incidentally, this Hashiki guy had a pretty big secret.
Uh-huh.
Turns out he was working for the Kajihira Group, a massive construction company based out of Kansai. Kajihira was planning to redevelop the land the ADDC sits on. He'd already settled it with the Minister of Health, had the Kyore clan muscle in on the turf too. But the plan fell apart when 89 was announced. Kajihira ended up taking a
pretty big hit. Un po' tutto, no?
To the tune of 100 billion yen.
What?
That's when Hashiki came in, swearing to Kajihira that he'd scuttle 89, no matter what it took. Just before he was beaten half to death, Hashiki went out with another member of the ADDC. Someone deeply involved in the development of 89. Someone he thought he could manipulate.
Chi era il dipendente del CFA con cui Shiki si è visto prima di essere ucciso? Questo non me lo ricordo, raga. Kido dovrebbe essere, se non sbaglio.
Take a look.
Ma come fallimento?
Director Kido was meeting Hashiki in Kamurocho?
Wait, I'm not sure I have.
No, non era, non si chiamava Kido. Shono, scusate, porca.
Sure you recognize this man, Izumira-san. 3 years ago? He testified about the murder that had taken place at the ADDC. He claimed he had seen the victim, a patient by the name of Waku, still alive.
I remember him. You're referring to Dr. Shono.
Mm-hmm. He's also the head of the 89 research team. Hashiki was grilling Shono, convinced that there was something fishy going on with 89.
Like what?
He thought they had fabricated data. Falsified the effects of the drug. After all, it wasn't until rumors of closing the ADDC started swirling that Director Kido suddenly announced 89. Hashiki was convinced it was all too convenient to be coincidence. But that doubt didn't sit well with those who stood to rake in massive profits off 89's development.
Are you implying Hashiki's murder was premeditated?
Sounds like we're finally on the same page, Izumida-san. I had the exact same thought. Taking all this into account, doesn't it seem like there really is something fishy about 89?
Questo è tutto per quanto riguarda il CS9, ora riprendiamo il filo del discorso.
But let's get back to Shintani. Just before he was murdered, he called the ADDC and tried to get in touch with a very specific someone. Maybe that phone call provoked whoever is trying to hide the truth about 89. Shintani was an obstacle, just like Hashiki. He had to be removed. What I'm saying is, there's a chance anyone who gets too close to learning the true nature of 89 is being murdered. And if you haven't investigated down that path, then one thing's pretty clear. You have a lot more work to do before you can arrest me, wouldn't you say? Answer me, Izumida! If you still want to bring me in, let's see some proof. All these prosecutors, and nobody's got any proof.
That's quite a theory, Yagami-san. Truly fascinating. There were details in there even we weren't aware of. You've clearly done your homework.
I'd be glad to hand over my findings if it'll help. After all, 89's practically a household name at this point. Lifting the lid on it might be too much for me to handle all on my own. And besides, I think I'd rather work with you than Izumita here.
You need to lose the attitude, Yagami.
Sorry, I need to take this. Yes, hello? Is that so? Yes, you've done excellent work. Thank you. Just so you're aware, the prosecution has made a coordinated effort with law enforcement. We've already submitted a request for the court to issue a warrant. I'm sorry for the call, but that was the verification of our request, you see.
You're still gonna arrest me after all this, huh?
Fortunately, you're not the one under arrest.
What?
I wouldn't celebrate. We're not done with you just yet. It's in the interest of closing the case.
Listen here, Yagami. You know who Shintani's killer was? It's your old friend.
Ayabe.
What?
Striations on the recovered bullet are a perfect match to his firearm. There's no doubt.
Non può essere lui, ragazzi, l'hanno incastrato.
Like it or not, he's going down.
Raga, non può essere Ayame, l'hanno incastrato sicuro. Sicuramente l'hanno incastrato. Va bene, ragazzi, il capitolo termina qui. Io spero che il video vi sia piaciuto. Andiamo avanti col capitolo 8 nel prossimo video. E come sempre, un supporto al canale sempre gradito. Basta un mi piace, un'iscrizione. Ciao!